All right, scholars, let's take a look at some of the concepts from this unit. I'd like you to make a graphic organizer, set it up the way I have here, at rest, constant velocity, and constant acceleration. We're going to look at what the graphs for these three types of motion would look like, and we're going to take a look at the relevant equations. So first, at rest. If you were to do a ticker tape for an object at rest, you would just see a dot that doesn't move. If you were going to make a position versus time graph for that, you would have x on the vertical, time on the horizontal, and it's at rest. So whatever its position, it would just be a straight, flat line. And it could be anywhere. It could also be along the horizontal, or directly along the axis. If we were going to make a position versus time graph, I'm sorry, velocity versus time graph, we can label it like this. Then this graph would have to be right along the axis because there is no velocity for it at all. V equals zero. So over here, there are really no equations for an object at rest. Let's take a look at the situation for constant velocity. If we're going to make ticker tape marks for this, we would note that the spacing is constant interval. They're evenly spaced. So this would be for something maybe going slow. This would be for an object going fast, spaced a little further. The position versus time graphs would look like this. We'll try to bring in some different colors here. For an object that's going slow, we would have a straight line, but at a very slight angle. So if we have an object here that's traveling slowly, it's going to be a straight line with little slope. If we have an object that is going with a fast constant velocity, it's going to also be a straight line, but it's going to be more steep. So here's fast, and here's slow. Let's draw what the velocity versus time would look like. So here's our V, here's our T. For the slow, it's going to be a constant velocity, but a small number. So this is going to be flat, slow. And over here is going to be the graph for fast. It's a constant velocity, so the constant velocity is staying this value, and it's greater than the velocity value over here. Let's take a look at constant acceleration. So something that is experiencing constant acceleration, the dots are going to start slow, but get further apart as it gets faster and faster. So the position versus time graph, x versus t, we've seen is going to do the swoosh. For a slow object, the swoosh is going to be a little further out there. For an object that's traveling faster, the swoosh is going to be a little tighter, like this. So this would be an object that's accelerating fast acceleration, and this one's going to be slow acceleration. The velocity versus time graphs. They're going to be looking like this. For the slow acceleration, they're going to be a straight line with not much slope. For the object that's doing fast acceleration, it's going to also be a straight line, but faster or steeper. So what this graph is showing us is that it is experiencing constant acceleration because it's a straight line, and this slope is greater, indicating a faster change of velocity. Let's take a look at the equations. For constant velocity, the velocity is going to be the displacement over the time interval, or if we're doing how far, delta x equals the speed times the time that it's moving. And if we want to find the time it takes to go a certain distance, we have delta t equals delta x over b. The equations for constant acceleration, if we want to find the velocity of something, we're talking about the instantaneous velocity. It'll be the rate of acceleration times the time accelerating plus initial velocity. And we can rearrange this equation. We can use this equation to solve for time if we wanted to. Let's take a look at our equations for acceleration. The acceleration of an object is equal to its change in velocity over the time it took for that. And another way of writing this would be a equals v final minus v initial over the time interval. We can rearrange this to say v final equals acceleration times time plus initial velocity. And we got that just simply by doing a little cross multiplying, putting a over 1 like that. All right. The other equation that is important for this is the how far equation. So up here, for constant velocity, it was simply speed times time. Here, for acceleration, it's going to be a little different. It's going to look like this. Delta x equals 1 half times the rate of acceleration times time accelerating squared. And if you did have an object that has some initial velocity to it, you could add in this term, plus vi times delta t. But we're not really doing problems that have initial velocity when accelerating. All of ours have had initial velocity equal to 0. So we can just forget about that term. All right, take a look at the next video where we're going to do one other kind of graphic organizer to help you understand the difference between these three types of motion.